When I was little, I always dreamt of living in the home of the future, where everything was automated and voice controlled. Though the home of the future is becoming more and more of a reality, the cost of having such a smart home can be very pricey. And frankly, I think I can do it myself much cheaper. So let's see if I'm right. So here's the basic idea of what I'm trying to create. Something that can turn the lights on and off, that can be controlled wirelessly, either from my phone or through voice or both. And also something that is relatively cheap. Can I do it? I don't know. So let's start tinkering. In order to remotely turn this lamp on and off, I'll need something to control the flow of power. One good method of doing this is by using a relay. Basically, it acts as a switch that is off until an external current is applied, which triggers the switching mechanism turning it on. I'll need to put this relay somewhere between the plug and the power source, which means I'll be messing with a dangerous amount of electricity. So I opted to go the safer route and just buy a pre-made 120-volt power cable with a relay already built in. Alright, the next thing to do is figure out how to trigger it. It's going to require some type of device that I can program to trigger the relay whenever I send it a command. My go-to device for such a task is an Arduino, which is a simple-to-use microcontroller. So what I can do is connect these two relay terminals to these two Arduino terminals, and then I can connect the Arduino to a computer and upload this code. This code tells the Arduino that whenever I send it a 1 from my computer, it turns the lights on, and whenever I send it a 2, it turns the lights off. And it totally works, but it's not a wireless solution. To solve that problem, I opted to go with Bluetooth for its short-range proximity and its easiness to pair with Android devices. Connecting it to an Arduino was equally as easy. You just connect the TX to RX and the RX to TX and the VCC to power and then the ground to ground. Then I tweaked the code a little bit to allow for commands through the Bluetooth, and that was it for the Arduino side. Now on to the next challenge, which is controlling it from the Android side. What I ended up doing was making an app using App Inventor that connects the device through Bluetooth and can send it commands. I made it so that if the on button was pressed, it would send a value of 1 to the Arduino, and if off was pressed, it sends it 2. As an added bonus, I found that I could also add voice recognition using App Inventor. I made it so that if the word on was spoken, it sends a value of 1, and when off is spoken, it sends the value of 2. Then I put everything in a nice little case and tested it out. Lamp on. Lamp off. You can download my app from the App Store using the link below, or you can watch my behind the scenes video if you want to make your own. If you have any ideas that you'd like to see, please submit or vote for your favorites at tinkernut.com/ideas. Again, you can click here to watch my behind the scenes video, or you can click here to watch more of my automation videos. If you enjoyed this video and would like to support my channel, please feel free to like, subscribe, comment, follow me on social media, or donate at tinkernut.com/donate. All right, that's it for this tutorial. For more, go to tinkernut.com.